In this video, we're going to bend text along a path. So I'm going to start here with the draw tool and select that. And I'm going to click once on the screen with my mouse. And you see, as soon as I do this, we get this line that follows the mouse around. I'm just going to come along a little bit and just click again, but this time I'm going to hold my mouse down as I click. So I'm going to click and hold my mouse. You can see now, as we move the mouse, I'm still holding it down, the mouse key. It creates a curve. So I'm going to create a curve, something like that. And then I let go of the mouse and then I move it up. And you can see I can create the other part of the curve here. So just move it up to where I like. And then I'm going to click just once with my mouse. And there you can see the curve is formed, but it's still following me around at this point. So I'm just going to press the escape key to stop it from doing that. So now we've got our nice curve here. And what I'm going to do is click on the select key here. And I'm going to click on it and just change it to a color that's a little bit more obvious. It's a bit hard to see. So there we go. So we've got our curve done. And now what we want to do is just type in our text. So I'm going to click on the text tool, click on the screen, and I'm going to type in my text. Okay, so I've got my text there. Just move it along in place here. Now, what I'm going to do next is give it a color. So I'm going to come down here. I've selected it. So come down and choose another color here. Okay, so what that does is it puts the line that I created on a separate layer. So the line, the first line is here, the curved line, and this is the text here on another line. And now all I want to do is, with the select key selected, I'm going to highlight. So I'm clicking from the right here and I'm highlighting everything. And then all I need to do now is right click and come down to apply path to text. So I click there and you can see now the text is sitting along that curve. Now you can see it's cut off some of the text, so I really need to make that text a little smaller. So I'm just going to click away and then click back onto the text so that I can get the spacing here. So I can just reduce the sizing there, and now my text fits along that path. And you'll also notice now that there is a line running through the center. Now you might want that line there, that's fine. If you don't want that to output to your laser, all you need to do is come over, and where the line is, you can select this option here to disable it, so it won't actually be sent to your laser, so it won't cut or draw a line or anything. And you can also actually stop it from showing on the screen completely by clicking here. See, and the line is now gone. So all you're left with is that curved text. Now you've also got other options. I'll just click those two back on. If you want that text, if you want the line to still appear and you want the text to appear above it, you can do that, or below it. So I'll just show you that. So I'm going to select the text. And then you can see these options up here. So we've got align Y, and currently it's set to middle. So if I click on the little up and down arrows, now I can select it to bottom. So the line now appears on the bottom, or you can make it appear on the top like that. And you've got another option here. You can also select the spacing of the text. So you can select that and you can see how it changes the width between the letters there. So you just can change it to suit how you want this to look. So that's pretty much it. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, please give us a thumbs up. We'd really appreciate it. And don't forget to subscribe for more like this.